After the processing of the Sentinel-1 images using the SNAP software, we shall now embark into the processing of the Sentinel-2 images, and these we shall use QGIS. We shall now use the QGIS software for the access and the processing of the Sentinel-2 images. Once we have launched the QGIS software, we shall go to the projects and open a new project. Once this is open, we shall go to the plugins, manage and install plugins, and go to all plugins. Once we are here, we shall select the semi-automatic classification plugin. This is a plugin that we shall be using for to access and also to process the Sentinel-2 images. So once it is selected, we click on Install Plugin. Once the process is finished, then we can click on Close. Once the semi-automatic classification plugin has been added, we can now go ahead and add the study area to the map. This. And therefore, we would like to download Sentinel-2 images for this study area. And therefore, we go back to the semi-automatic classification tool. We go to the download products. And we go to download products. We start with putting in our login credentials. And these we shall use the same credentials that we used for the Sentinel-1 data. And once that is done, we go to the search. On the search button, we need to define the area where we'll be getting our Sentinel-2 images. So we will click on this plus sign. And once you've done that, we go back to our map. Select on the top left-hand corner, left-click, and then right-click the bottom right to select the area. Once that is done, we go back to our tool, semi-automatic classification plugin, and we find that the area has been defined. After that, we select the product, it's Sentinel-2. We know the period we need them for, so we will do for the whole of 2018. The reason being, the main purpose we need the Sentinel-2 images for this study is to identify the field boundaries on which agriculture is practiced. So we select January 1st, 2018 up to 31st December 2018. We then set the maximum cloud cover to 10. Once that is done, we click on Find. Once the process is complete, a list of available images for the year 2018 are displayed. A preview of the available images can be seen by clicking on any of the numbers and seeing the image, the preview of the image. Alternatively, we can go to the cloud cover image and look for the image with the least cloud cover. In our case, we have the list is 0.5. And for that reason, we shall use the image number 7 for further pre-processing. Therefore, all other images that we don't need, we shall delete them. To do this, we shall select all the images above, and click on delete row, you confirm yes. Then we shall delete all the images below. We shall confirm yes. Therefore, we are just left with the image with the list cloud cover. Now that we have the download image that you'd like to download, we go to the download options, and for the Sentinel-2, we can select the bands that you'd like to download. Here we shall select all of them. We shall uncheck the only if preview layers icon, and then leave the preprocessing icon checked, as well as loading the bands in QGIS. Once this is done, we click on Run. We select where we'd like the images to be saved. And we'll go to our working folder. We will create a new folder and call it the Sentinel-2 results. And the process shall start. Once the process is complete, the pre-processed Sentinel-2 images are loaded onto the QGIS, and now we can close the semi-automatic classification plugin. This is the image that we have been able to download and pre-process. In its natural form, we may not be able to appreciate the various boundaries that exist. We shall therefore create a virtual band, which shall assist us in visualizing the images, the fields in the ground. To do this, we shall go to Raster, Miscellaneous, and then we say Build Virtual Raster. In the input parameters, we shall select the layers that you'd like to use, and we shall use the RGB, the red, blue, and green bands, and these in Sentinel-2, we know are the bands 2, 3, and 4. So we shall select band 2, band 3, and band 4. And we shall click OK. And then we shall click on Run.